咚咚锵，咚锵咚锵。Hello, everybody. Today is day 7 of our Spring Festival, or we call it Chinese New Year's. And in our traditional Chinese New Year, day 7, we are calling the Human Birthday. So I wish you all a very good happy birthday and have a nice day here. And anyway, I'm continuing with my focus main point here because this week we have another week of the EPL prediction. So last week, because of the Chinese New Year festival, I give myself a little bit holiday here and I have a rest here. But this week, I continue to my Premier League prediction video. This week, we're going on week 25. And look on the earlier game, we already has a big game here. Leicester City versus Chelsea. These two teams currently, Leicester City in third and Chelsea on fourth position. And these two positions can make themselves in the next season Champions League stage. Leicester City looking a little bit safe on the third position because there are several disturbed with the fourth position. But Chelsea, they only 5-point leads against the fifth position Manchester United, Wolverhampton and Tottenham Hotspur. These three are on the 7-point at fifth position. So I think this is not a very safe position for Chelsea. So they need to chase a point here. However, Leicester have home advantage and they, I think they have a very good attacking line. They have a good attacking line. They have players like Jamie Vardy, James Maddison and a little good substitute man like Andy Gray, Iheanacho. So I think there is no problem with their attacking. And you can see in past 1 or 2 months, they almost win all the game. And once before, they are the closest challenge for the leader Liverpool. And Chelsea, sometimes they also make some surprising here. They may lose the game to the weak also, but they may also beat the strong. And in this game, I think both of them need the point here. I pick a draw. 1-1 draw for this game. Second game is AFC Bournemouth versus Aston Villa. Okay, last game, both of this team beat their opponent in the same scoreline. 2-1. And this game, I think the AFC Bournemouth had the home advantage. Last weekend, they beat Brighton and their opponent Aston Villa beat Watford. So I think AFC Bournemouth can continue their winning streak with a home advantage here. My prediction here is 2-0. Third game is Crystal Palace versus Sheffield United. In the last game, Crystal Palace lost to Southampton at home. While Sheffield United also lost at home, they lost to the defending champion Manchester City. So there is nothing very sad, nothing very surprised if Sheffield United lost to Manchester City. But I think Sheffield United once is a good promotion team before. They're in the very good position as a promotion team. And Crystal Palace last week, they lost to Southampton. But I think they need a point here. So I go for the home team, Crystal Palace. I think they can win a 3-point here. 1-0 for Crystal Palace beating Sheffield United. Next game is Liverpool versus Southampton. Okay, in the last game, we know Liverpool beat West Ham. After they beat West Ham, this officially we can say Liverpool already beat all the 9 teams Premier League team this season. Let's clap for them. This is an incredible performance, yeah? But they have another record or another target to achieve. That is unbeaten run in the Premier League. If they can do that, they can. Same with Arsenal, who does it before. But I think the Liverpool, if does it, they also have a higher achievement because they win more of the game compared to the Arsenal unbeaten record. So with this challenging and with this encouraging record, I think Liverpool can continue their unbeaten streak. Maybe they will lose some games, but I don't think they will lose in this game. Maybe in some games afterward. However, this game, I still pick Liverpool win. 2-1. Next is Newcastle United versus Norwich City. So last week, Newcastle stopped the Carlos Ancelotti Everton. They drew 2-2 there. Norwich lost to the Jose Mourinho Tottenham Hotspurs. 1-0. And I think this game, Newcastle can back to the winning streak. They can back to their winning form with the home advantage here. They beat Norwich City 1-0. And I think both of these two teams need the point to escape further from the relegation zone. I pick the home team.
Newcastle won. Next game, Watford versus Everton. Okay, last week, Watford lost to Aston Villa and Everton, they have drawn with Newcastle, we already mentioned above. And last weekend, Everton missed the point against Newcastle. But we knew after the Carlo Ancelotti took out the Everton, they have a little bit rest up their performance. Once they're almost in the relegation zone, but after Carlo Ancelotti put hands on Everton, they already win a lot of games and chase back a lot of points. So in this game, I believe they can continue this good form. My prediction, Everton take another win, 3-1 Everton. Next, West Ham United versus Brighton and Hove Albion. Okay, these two teams lost to their opponent, West Ham 1-4 lost to Leicester City, and Brighton 1-2 lost to AFC Bournemouth. So in this matter, I think home team maybe have advantage here. If in the luck in the above game, I pick home team can win by this situation, but this time I pick another way. I pick Brighton as a away team can beat West Ham United here. Actually, I think these two teams is quite balanced here, and they almost in the very same position, and almost I think their power and attacking and defensive also not very much different. But I pick Brighton and Hove Albion because I believe Brighton and Hove Albion sometimes can have an amazing play here. Sometimes they can beat the Storm also. My prediction here, Brighton 2-1. Next game is interesting. Is a big game also. Manchester United versus Wolverhampton Wanderers. Currently, these two teams are on the same points. They both tied at 34 with another team, Tottenham Hotspur. These three teams is tied at 34. So after this week, who will take over? Who? We still don't know. But these two teams face together, Manchester and Wolverhampton. Of course, it's the main event here. So this is a game very challenging for these two teams because this is also a deciding game for the next season Champions League stage. They need to chase the fourth position Chelsea if they need to make themselves compete in the next season Champions League game. So they need 3 points here. And I think Man United have a little bit advantage here. And this weekend they have a good news. Their targets, Bruno Fernandes, are already arrived at Manchester United and officially announced he is the new sign of United this winter transfer window. I think Bruno Fernandes is a good attacking and a good playmaker that Man United miss when they face some tough and defending team. They can beat strong, but they always lose to promotion and weak team because I think their attacking line is very uncreative. With the joining of Bruno Fernandes, can this changing the situation? We still don't know. Maybe Bruno still need the time to switch to the team and to the Man United playing form. But I think Man United can have a win here because in FA Cup they beat Wolverhampton before at Old Trafford, and this time I think they can be repeat this performance. Same scoreline I given as FA Cup 1-0 for Manchester United. Next, Burnley versus Arsenal. This is also a very interesting game. Last game, Burnley surprisingly beat Man United at Old Trafford, and this forced some Manchester United fans a little bit frustrated and disappointed. And in that game, I see many of the fans already escaped from the stadium before the referee brought in the final whistle. And I heard that if Man United third management does not have any decision on the transfer market, they may do some provocation, they may do some provocation this game. However, with the Bruno Fernandes choice, I don't know this will happen or not. But however, this time Burnley versus Arsenal in this past few game, they lose many points. I'm not saying that they lost the game, but they draw to their opponent in many times. You know, in our football term, if you draw means you lost 2 points. Win get you 3 points, draw only 1 point. So if you win 3 games, you get 9 points, but if you draw 3 games, you only get 3 points, equal to 1 win. Arsenal lost too many points due to the draw factor. And I think if they still continue to hope to play the Europe League next season, they really need to chasing 3 points here. I believe Burnley good luck maybe run away after they beat Man United last season. So I pick Arsenal. My prediction here, Arsenal back to the winning form. 2-1 for Arsenal. Next is the big main event of this week. Tottenham Hotspur versus Manchester City. Okay, as we mentioned above, Tottenham Hotspur is the same point, 34. They are same point against Man United and Wolverhampton who will fetch on this week. So if Tottenham can win here, maybe they have a chance to passing and rest their position. But however, their opponent also tough. Currently on the second position, Manchester City, and they also declared themselves a defending champion. So if Man City want to survive and want to continue to save and protect their second position, I think they need to win. Spurs, after Jose Mourinho took up the team, Spurs can have a good form, but in opposite way, because we know Jose Mourinho is good in the defensive play, but what I see, Spurs already conceded many goals in mini games. This is something very surprised and abnormal for me. However, Man City also have a defensive problem here. I'm no doubt with their attacking line with a player like Sterling, Aguilar, Kevin De Bruyne. But however, their defensive is still the main problem for them. But luckily, last game, their main center back, Laporte, already back in the team. I think this will a little bit improve the Man City defensive line. So I believe they are more tough on the defensive now. I pick Man City 2-1 for Manchester City. So this is all my 10 games on this weekend. You all can join and collapse with me. You can guess and comment your result below. And this is nothing paid here. It's all free. Just guess for fun. Just get for your own interest. So join and collab with me. I hope more fans, we can enjoy it together, and we will see you on my next prediction video. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.